I worked with a lady once who was suicidally depressed. She lived at home with her family. She was in her 50s, and she spent all day sitting in a corner, face to the corner. She wouldn't talk to anyone. She wouldn't eat with anyone. She was totally uncommunicative. She was under the care of a psychiatrist, of course, as she should be. And the psychiatrist had her on a variety of medications, which you would expect. The family was wondering about nutrition. And I mentioned to them about Dr. Hoffer's work with niacin. And they wondered how much she needed to take. This person was very seriously ill. And I mentioned that Dr. Hoffer normally gave about 3,000 milligrams a day of niacin, but some people need a lot more, especially very sick people, and they should give her as much as it takes to make her better. Well, they figured they could do that. So at 11,500 milligrams of niacin a day, she was sitting at the table and talking to them like nothing had happened. So they went to the psychiatrist, showed the psychiatrist this recovered person, and the psychiatrist said, well, I don't think you should take all that niacin. It might be harmful. So they stopped giving her the niacin, and she was back in the corner. Safety with niacin? There's not one death from niacin per year, on average. There have been one or two attributed over the last 15 or 20 years. But there's not even one death per year from niacin. And how many people that are suicidally depressed actually go and end their lives?